I hope everyone is doing fine. Okay, let us discuss one topic today in science regarding plant adaptation. If you see the plants and trees, do they grow in all in the same area or same climate? No, there is a lot of variations. Some plants will grow in hot climate, some will grow in cold climate, some will grow in both the climates. Okay, let us learn more in detail today. First, coming to the habitat. The place where an organisms naturally live is called a habitat. Now it is plant adaptations. So the special feature acquired by all the organisms to naturally live and adapt to its habitat is called as plant adaptation. It is called as adaptation. So we will learn more about plant adaptations today. Our next, terrestrial plants. The plants which live on land are called as terrestrial plants. So these terrestrial plants are classified into plants in deserts, plants on mountains and hills, plants in plains, plants in marshy areas, plants in forest, plants in coastal areas. So this is a classification of terrestrial plants which live on land. They are called as terrestrial plants. Now let us learn more in detail one by one. First one, it is plants in deserts. See, this is a picture of a cactus tree. Yeah. So these plants will be grown in a hot and dry climate. And the stem will be thick and fleshy. As the stem is thick and fleshy, it will store the water which is used for the photosynthesis. Next, the leaves are modified to spines. The leaves are modified to spines, which is used to prevent and also stores the water. And the roots of these plants are deep into the ground. Why? To absorb the ground water. So the plants in deserts, it is grown in hot and cold climate. The stem will be thick and fleshy. So it will store the water, collect the water and store the water which is used for the photosynthesis. The leaves are modified to spines and the roots will be long, deep into the ground, which will be deep into the ground so that it will be collect the underground water. Next, plants on mountains and hills. The trees, if you see the picture, this is a picture of a pine tree. So the trees are straight. The trees will be straight and they are tall and they are cone shaped and they have waxy coating and they are also like needle shaped. Because of all these features, what will happen? Mostly these plants will be grown in a cold climate, like snow areas. So if there is heavy snowfall, snowfall in that area, what will happen? The snow will be slide off from their branches because of these special features. Next, coming to the plants in plains. The plants in plains will be grown in both hot and cold climate. They are grown in both hot and cold climate. Example, it is mango tree. So if you see the picture, the plant has many branches, many leaves, many fruits and many flowers. Okay. So the plants in plains have many branches, many flowers, many fruits, and they have plenty of branches also. Now these plants in plains are classified into two types: deciduous forest and evergreen forest. Deciduous forest, the plants shed the leaves. The plants of the leaves shed in the autumn and grow back in spring. So what will happen? The leaves will fall off in autumn season and grow back again into the spring season. So they are called as deciduous forest. Next one, it is evergreen forest. They shed their leaves. They shed their leaves throughout the year and grow back again. So they are called as evergreen forests. Next, coming to the plants in marshy areas. The marshy area is nothing but it is wet clay and sticky soil with water covering their surface. The marshy area is wet. It is clay and sticky soil. So it is sticky with water covering the surface. So what will happen? It will develop the roots. It will develop the roots. So these roots are used to for the plant to breathe. So these are called as breathing roots. These are also called breathing roots. So and also called as mangroves. Next, coming to the plants in forest. Compared to all these adaptations, the plants in forest receive more rainfall. And the plants grow tall and it has abundant leaves. And also the tall with the broad and abundant leaves because of the rainfall. The example is redwood. Next, coming to the last one, the plants in coastal area. You can see this is a coconut picture, yeah. So the example of this is a coconut plant. So if you see the coconut plant, how it is tall and it is straight. So it is adapted to the characteristic of which has salty water. It will grow in a salty water. That area it will grow, and also it requires heavy rainfall. Okay, let us recap once again. First, what do you mean by terrestrial plants? The plants which live on land are called as terrestrial plants. So these are classified into plants in desert, plants on mountains and hills, plants in plains, plants in marshy areas, plants in forest, plants in coastal areas. Okay, thank you.